What's up guys, it's me or Jimmy a Geek. So here is another great video for the LG G7 camera lens. What's up guys, it's me Jimmy a Geek. So here's another unboxing and a lens test. First let me do the unboxing and then I'm going to put this lens on my Panasonic G7, which is the best 4K camera, which is the best budget 4K camera, which is the best YouTube camera. Again, thinking to start a YouTube channel? LG G7, do not buy LG GH4 or any other camera. This is personal recommendation from Jimmy Aki. So this is a lens I bought. I was just watching a video of another guy, I forgot his name, maybe I can put his YouTube channel link. So he's using this lens. This is a 25mm 1.7 aperture. There's no zoom. This one currently you can buy for $200. Some people have picked for $99 on a Black Friday sale. That is the same way a lot of people have picked up the Xbox for $200, the Battlefield 1 edition. Currently I'm paying like $350 again, I mean, because Black Friday is gone. So this is a very good lens. I mean, 1.7 aperture. If you don't know about aperture, let me tell you one thing. Lowers the aperture, more light can go in. Normally the LG G7 kit lens is 3.5 aperture compared to 1.7. Again, the lower the aperture, 1.7 is better than 3.5 because it's lower, so more light can go in. That is the simple rule. So let me do this one. Come in a white box. So let's see. I mean, this is the international version or the Japanese version. Okay, you can easily buy this one from Amazon. There's another with the USA version, with USA warranty from Amazon. Even I can include that link. That is like $50 more. Normally we do not need, I mean, I will say do not pay for like extra $50 for a 1 year guarantee for $200 lens. I mean, above anything $500-600, then you should pay. So this is a model number H-H025. So you'll be thinking, I mean, which device I'm recording this video with. I'm using my Nokia Lumia 1520 4K video feature, which is the, I'm extremely sorry guys, my Nokia Lumia 1520 just shut down due to the overheating. This phone is like 3 years old, more than 3.5 years old, if I'm not wrong. I bought it back in 2013, now it's like 2017. So here's a lens. It comes with this lens hood for the including the price. I'm really very happy. So let me show you the lens. So it's a 25mm micro HD. Micro and HD. HD is very good for taking high definition images and video. H-H025. So this is the right lens. So there's nothing, there is some kind of like warranty, which I don't know will it work in Hong Kong. So this is a real lens. If it do not come with any this kind of warranty, mostly there is not a single fake lens of this version on the market. There can be used. So yeah, so now let me just clean off my table and then I'm going to put the lens on my Nokia Lumia 1520. I have a simple question from you guys. Do you like to use a lens hood while shooting inside? Maybe I'm going to do a test with and without the lens hood. So yeah, now the table is clear. Now let me grab my G7 to put it on. So currently I'm using the Panasonic Lumix 25mm lens. So this is how it's going to, I mean, shoot. Like currently I'm recording on autofocus. I'm not using any peaking function, only on autofocus, the basic setting autofocus, and then like I'm using a face tracking mode. Yes, I'm using a face tracking mode. Before I was using the one pin mode, it was like focusing on the back, not my face, my lovely handsome face. It's not focusing. I was feeling really bad. I mean I'm a really handsome guy, isn't it? I was feeling very bad. It's like focusing behind my stupid laptop, behind the wall. A handsome guy is in front of the camera. So I put into a face tracking mode. I'm a newbie. I had been using DSLR a lot, especially Sony DSLR. I was a big Sony fan, but because now Sony tried to, I mean, mess with me, I bought a camera under warranty of Sony. It fell down. Okay, there's a dent, the lens is not working. And then now what Sony did, Sony asked me to pay $23 for the inspection. A camera under warranty. I say okay, the camera is okay, it's broken, you just need to replace a lens. So how much is going to cost under warranty? You just give me a quote, a quotation.
They said, no, we are going to first charge you $23 and then we are going to tell you how much we are going to charge you. If you're not getting the point, again, I'm going to tell you. Sony said they are going to charge me to just tell me how much they are going to charge me later on. The video will be in the card. Click the card button to watch. I mean, it really make me mad. So I said, screw Sony. I was a Sony fan, but I own every Sony headphone, every Sony camera, every Sony PlayStation system. I'm a big Sony fan, but I mean Sony voice recorder, Sony radio, Sony Walkman. Do you remember Sony Walkman? I mean Sony phone, Sony Ericsson, okay, to be precise. I did not own a single Sony brand phone after, I mean, the breakaway of Ericsson and Sony. I own Sony Ericsson phone. So now I finally pick up a Panasonic. Panasonic and Sony both are a giant Japanese company. So I'm just using a lens in an indoor environment with one light only, with one fluorescent light only, to be honest with you. Only one light only. Maybe I can take an image of a light which I'm using. Only I'm using one light. I bought this camera as I bought this lens. I bought this lens 1.7 aperture lens, so the more light the lens can get, the thumb of the rule is that the lower the aperture, the better the light can go in. For example, I mean 1.7 is like this, I mean more light can go in. 3.5 is like this, less light can go in. I'm not an expert. I'm a digital guy. I did my certificate in digital photography. Remember one thing, I'm a digital guy. Digital world is very different than the DSLR, mirrorless photography and video. I have been using Sony DSLR only for the photography. The last Sony DSLR I bought it was Sony A550, which do not have a video recording, I mean, capability as a feature. So it was only a regular, I mean, mid-level DSLR. I never ever record a video on DSLR or mirrorless. I really do not know much about the mirrorless and DSLR, right? I'm going to do more research on it. Mirrorless, I know the lens, the lens engineering is different than a DSLR, so that's why it's compact. But at the end of the day, I will prefer mirrorless over the DSLR. Again, at the end of the day, I'm going to prefer a mirrorless over the DSLR. DSLR, dang, no one is going to accept. I mean, my new Sony, which just break down, Sony WX500, which is a digital compact camera, replaced my DSLR. Today, a $500 Sony camera or a $500 digital camera can give you like a much better quality than the entry level DSLR. That is a fact. But mirrorless is a little bit different. Especially mirrorless is better for the video, because for a $500-$600 mirrorless camera, you are getting a video quality of a $2,000 camera recorder, to be honest with you. I hope so. I bought this lens under the recommendation of a YouTuber. Under of the YouTuber G7 lens. The name is Art of the Image. Art of the Image. The YouTuber is called Art of the Image. Yeah, maybe I can include his link in the description box below. Yes, the Art of the Image. He's a very good guy. I mean, he said he normally uses this lens, so I bought it. At the end of the day, I really want to step on my YouTube game. I hope so. The lens is clear enough. Currently, I'm not applying any UV filter or a protector, so you are seeing what the lens is seeing. So I hope you like my video. If you want to support me, you can buy this lens from the description box below. It will help me to grow my channel. It will help me to build my channel. Bye.